Hello guys. So I'll be discussing today about the change of trigonometric ratios in the different quadrant. So this will be the first quadrant, second, third, and fourth. So like we discussed in the previous video, that how it changes for the y-axis, that is for the complementary, and how it changes for the supplementary angle. So for this x-axis, for x-axis and for y-axis. For y-axis, sine trigonometric ratio will change into cos. Cos will change into sine. Tan will change into cot. Cot will change into tan. Cosec will change into sec. And sec will change into cosec. This will be for the y-axis. For the x-axis, sine will remain sine, cos will be cos, tan will be tan, cot will be cot, now sec will be sec, and cosec will be cosec. Now, how it changes for the different quadrant? In the first quadrant, all trigonometric ratio will remain positive. In the second quadrant, sine and its reciprocal cosec will remain positive and rest all will be negative. In the third quadrant, tan and its reciprocal cot will be positive and rest all will be negative. In the fourth quadrant, cos and its reciprocal sec will be positive, rest all trigonometric ratios will be negative. So how it changes? That we need to check now. So for the first quadrant it's already done, so I'll be doing it for the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, till its angle 90. So if in second quadrant it will be more than 90, this is pi by 2, this angle pi by 2, pi by 2 radian. So pi by 2 added something added to pi by 2 will come into the second quadrant. So for the second quadrant, we'll check for the different trigonometric ratios. So for this, suppose sine pi by 2, in the angle pi by 2, in pi by 2, this will be pi by 2, and here angle theta, this is added. So sine pi by 2 plus theta. Pi by 2 plus theta means that this is coming in the second quadrant. Something added to pi by 2 means that this is coming in the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, sine and its reciprocal cosec will be positive and rest all will be negative. So this will be, and if this is related to pi by 2 means that for the y-axis, so for this sine will change into cos. So cos, and this will be theta, and this will be positive, for this is the second quadrant. Now, for cos, pi by 2 plus theta, this will be changing to, cos will change into sine theta, and this will be negative, because sine and cosec will be positive, rest all will be negative in the second quadrant. Third, tan pi by 2 plus theta will be equal to, this will change into cot theta from here, tan will change into cot, and from the second quadrant, tan will be negative. Then cot pi by 2 plus theta, this will be changed into tan theta, and this is also the second quadrant, so this cot will be changed, first cot will be changed into tan, and second quadrant cot will be negative, so this will be negative. Next, what is left? Sine, cos, tan, cot, and then sec, pi by 2 plus theta, so this will be, sec will be changed into cosec theta, and this will be negative. Now, cosec pi by 2 plus theta, this will be changed into sec theta, and this will be positive, because the reciprocal of sine will, cosec will be positive, so this will be positive. So this is for the pi by 2 plus theta. Now the next will be for pi, from now we come here, like if we reduce some angle, let's suppose this will be 180 degree, that is pi. So pi minus theta means that this is still in the second quadrant only. So the sign will change like this only because this is in the second quadrant. But for this x axis, that is for this pi, sine will remain sine, cos means the trigonometric ratios will remain same. So for here, sine of pi by pi, sine of pi minus theta. Pi minus theta means somewhere like suppose this is theta and this will be this till here, this will be pi. So pi minus theta means that this is lying in the second quadrant only. So this will be equal to sine will remain sine only, sine theta. Now it's reciprocal, cosec pi minus theta. So this will be cosec theta only. Cosec will remain cosec. This is the second quadrant and reciprocal of sine, that's why positive and cosec theta. Now tan pi minus theta. This will be minus of, will remain same, so minus of tan theta. Now cot pi minus theta. So this will be minus of cot theta. Now sec pi minus theta. So cosec done, sec is left, so sec will be same. That is sec theta minus sine cosec. Now what is left? Cos is left. So cos pi minus theta. Cos will remain cos because this is the second quadrant and quadrant cos theta and this will be minus. Okay, so this is done for the second quadrant. Now if we come in the third quadrant, we'll come for in the same way we'll do for the third quadrant and for the fourth quadrant. For the third quadrant, sine of like pi, from here if theta is added, so this pi and this plus theta, so sine of pi plus theta. So in the third quadrant, this is coming in the third quadrant, this is pi, so this sine will remain sine, so this will be sine theta. And this is coming in third quadrant, so third quadrant tan and cot will be positive only and this term will be negative, so this will be negative. Next, cos of pi by pi plus theta. So this will be cos of theta positive. No, this will be negative. Now tan of pi plus theta. So this will be positive and tan will remain tan, so tan theta. Now cot of pi plus theta. So this will be positive of cos theta. Now sine reciprocal will be sec. Sine will be cosec. So cosec pi plus theta will remain same. So cosec, this will be negative theta. Then sec of pi plus theta. So this will be sec only, so sec minus of sec theta. In the same way, we'll find out for the fourth quadrant, then for related to this 270 degree, then in the fourth quadrant, and in this way, it will keep on moving. Okay, thank you for watching.